Hey everybody, it's Chaplain Sal, back for another coffee talk with the chaplain, another cup of coffee. As I just realized, I scratched my nose, so here's a little hand sanitizer. Clean my hands and my nose. My nose itches. Sorry, guys. Anyway. I know. I thought I'd come to you today and talk to you about a certain type of person. You'll notice, either whether it's my podcast I do with Pastor Todd or these videos, I occasionally end the video by saying, don't be a jerk. Sometimes I would rather use another word, and that word is asshole. Don't be an asshole. Did the chaplain just say a curse word? That's right. I do have the connotation around here of being the cursing chaplain, so if you think me saying asshole is bad, you haven't heard me talk. Anyway, cursing in context can be okay and appropriate. But I wanted to talk about don't be an asshole. What's an asshole? Generally, we think of an asshole as someone who is arrogant or ignorant or stupid or self-centered or selfish. There was a philosopher who said more specifically, they consider themselves more important than anybody else. So why is that important? Why am I talking about it? Well, because I wanted to talk in times of stress. We can very easily, because we're stressed out and anxious or angry, we can become assholes. We can think only about ourselves and not those around us. We forget the golden rule, do unto others as you would wish them to do unto you. We forget Jesus's rule, to love your neighbor. Because when we become self-centered and selfish and angry, we become assholes. But it's not about you. I'm sorry. In America, the land of individualism, me, 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 I can do what I want to do, rugged individualism, I hate to tell you, as a faith-based community, not about you. Let's take a look at a clip from a show called Afterlife. Ricky Gervais, he's a British comic. And I think exemplifies sort of the idea of not being focused on yourself. Let's take a look.
But then I realized you can't not care about things you actually care about. You can't fool yourself. And it was something you said, that it's not all about me. And even though I'm in pain, it's worth sticking around to maybe make my little corner of the world a slightly better place.
That's all there is. Happiness is amazing. It's so amazing, it doesn't matter if it's yours or not. It's that lovely thing. A society grows great when old men plant trees, the shade of which they know they will never sit in. Good people do things for other people. That's it, the end. And you're good, Tony. You have so much to give. Smart, funny, lovely.
You forgot sexy.
Yeah, well, didn't want to be too obvious.
If you were 20 years younger, right?
Exactly. Mind you, if I was 20 years younger, I think I could do better.
Yeah, definitely.
A society grows great when old men plant trees whose shade they will not sit in. Good people care about others. I know most of us don't intentionally set out to be assholes. We can be self-centered and selfish sometimes. I can be an asshole. Ask my wife. But if she points it out to me, I stop. And most of us can do that. If someone says, hey, you're being a jerk, don't be a jerk. Don't be an asshole. We can step back and say, oh, you're right. So don't be an asshole. Don't be a jerk. It's very important to live our lives right now and every day with the rule that John Wesley had. Do all the good you can in every place you can and every time you can. Always do good. There'll be days when you don't, but as long as you're willing to acknowledge that and focus on getting back to good, we can do it. All right, guys. This has been another coffee talk with the chaplain. Remember, don't be a jerk, don't be an asshole, and be excellent to each other. All right, guys. Rock on. See you later. The ground been kicked.